Welcome to my east side patio. Table is spread. Grab yourself your favorite beverages and join me on a little look-see as to what is going on my table here. I have my monthly silicon soak going. Normally I give everybody a good dose of 100 parts per million of silicon at 6.3 pH once a month during the summer months. And I've positioned them in such a way that I don't have to mess you around with regards to seeing which one's doing what. They're all pretty much in growth stage, and I'm pleased to say that the Chantilly lace right here is growing a gorgeous new growth, and I've got some great roots coming. This is the first time I'm not concerned about the growth of this orchid because it's been quite a little bit of a diatribe with it. It's just been languishing. But here we are now, many, many years later, and for the first time, no concerns. Here's my Maxima Alba that I got from the Orchid Room, Melissa Walker and Michael McCarthy. That's a great new growth for the season. Roots going in. And this is the Dawiana Alba with its stunning new growth coming in as well. Leptotus Bicolor, finally. I've got one new growth starting. Oh my goodness, that's taken a while. I wish it would be a little bit more vigorous, but I'll take one new growth. Didn't bloom for me this year. And here's my Golden Cella, which didn't bloom for me either during the winter. Normally I get a winter bloom, but that growth is looking great. New roots going in the pot. My Tibicinis right here, beautiful. Finally established in my Leca self-watering setup. New roots are growing, not just in the top, but also in and down below into the pot. Very pleased about that. Now we can start to mature the next new growths. Everything that's come out so far has been somewhat tiny, but that's okay. It's taken 2 years to get to this point. And I have her a little bit more shaded now for the last 2 months, not as exposed to the sunlight. And you can see how the color is not changing at all. Beautiful burgundy chocolate colored leaves. My Durigan, we've got a sheath on its new growth. That one arrived last year, around about August, I believe, from Floralia. And it tried on its growth that it came with. This growth was maturing. It tried to push a bud, but it was far too soon. But now we have a gorgeous, beautiful growth on this Durigan Crucero do Sul with a lovely sheath coming. So I'm pretty hopeful that this one will bloom for us this year. This is my Berryoda getting a silicon soak as well. Going nuts on new growth. If I turn the plant, which I'm not going to do because I don't want to damage any of the leaves of the other orchids. There's about 6-7 new growths in there. And this one is ready to be split and divided. So everybody that's asked for a piece of it know that I'm on it because now there's root growth coming from the growths, these new growths, and it's going to be radical and quite a lot of carnage to get this one and divide it into three pieces. But you can see just five new growths just in the front here. So yeah. I'm going to be very nervous, and there's probably going to be a repot where I'm going to be relatively quiet, but I'll take you through the process. Here's my Thomsoniana. I am getting a new growth as well on Thomsoniana, right there, tucked in, still very, very shy, but there's a new growth. And my Ancelia Africana finally is showing signs of what a vigorous orchid this is. So after 2 years of having it languishing, we had 1 year where it was then starting to produce new roots, but stunted little growths, that's okay. They always bring roots. I don't mind if they're stunted. Every growth will bring roots. But now we're finally getting into some action here with three growths coming, and we'll see how I can push them to their maximum. Maybe I have a pygmy Ancelia, who knows? Also getting a soak is the Neifetz Alex Poli, but we saw that in a recent video, but also on the silicon front here. And here is my Dinard Blue Heaven. Look at this growth. Ta-da. Wow. What a stonker. I love it. Beautiful sheath in there as well. Marvelous growth. My Fushu Glory Happy Holiday is right here. Also coming up with a beautiful growth, same, maybe a little bit bigger than the one previous, which did bloom. So looking forward to seeing Happy Holiday again. My mailman, Sunya Green Mailman. Yeah, we're again a little bit late to the party here. Never got this orchid to bloom, has attempted to bud several times, and they always blasted. Maybe third year is a charm, don't know. But this growth, I was expecting a little bit sooner. We'll see how quickly it can grow and develop into something substantial. And then here's Louise Fuchs, which is really growing nicely. Finally, I've got beautiful new growth coming right there, progressing well, and a second one emerging from the spider web over there. I was hoping for a third one, but I don't see it. There was plenty of eyes. Oh well, two is better than none. And this is my Cattleya dowiana. A little bit of a slowpoke, depending on how you look at it. The other growths are coming on really well. This one has maybe doubled in a month from when we last saw it. And back here is my Gulf Green Hair Pig, recovered from a massive division and root process cleanup last year. Finally, it has in the past months developed a new root system, and now that growth is looking really good. And I am actually expecting that it will bloom. Maybe I won't get two blooms this year, but that's not looking like a stunted growth. My Lelia perinii, hello, little one, or big one, doing good. Very pleased to see this one up and active already. Very early for me in my experience with this perinii. Moving over to the little fairy that I've got here. There comes the new growth for the season, and I'm hoping to recover the size of the orchid and the growths that I had in previous years. This was the growth of 2020, and that's 2021, so I hope it has recovered from my mishandling it in 2020. In the back here, Chunye Good Life. There we go. Look at that. Also, stonking growth. Love it. They're all coming out really nicely. Light training is working well. I'm facing them to the opposite angle of the sun, or the major light comes. I'm getting them to grow upright. And you can see that in many cases, I've removed the supports because there is no need for them anymore, as I show one with a support and one without. But little fairy, I'm keeping her together because I don't want to be bashing her around. If the new roots are coming, they need to stay protected there. Here's my Epidendrum or Coelostylus ciliaris crossed with Brassavola digbiana. This new growth is maturing. It's the first one of the season. The first one of the season, in my case, never blooms for me, but it always provides great roots. The second one is already underway, and that is already throwing out roots as well. And that one is the one that will bloom. So I get two growths per season. The first one doesn't bloom, the second one does. This is my Pinosa Wabash Valley here. Also had a massive, massive dissection and division process last year, and is now working on two growths. I would say the only beat it skipped was it took a while to realize that it had been taken apart. Then it sulked, but now we're back to behaving normally. So no detriment to this orchid. I'm sure that one of these growths are going to bloom. And back here, I have my Zagaric Wax African Beauty. Now, this one also went through a massive, massive cleanup operation. Huge division was taken out of it. So the growth of this year is never going to reach what it was prior. This growth bloomed for me last year. This one has a sheath, but it's not a bifoliate, so I don't know if it's even going to bloom. Maybe we'll get one bloom out of it, or two. I'll let it bloom because it's already giving me great roots into the pot. And then we saw Dimorphorchis lowii recently in a care collab. And if I can just scoot around without jiggling too much, that leaf is coming along nicely. I would say in the past week since we did the care collab, that has doubled as well in size. That's pretty fast considering this orchid. And then here's my Lelia zip. Let's get back here. You see that? There we go. These two growths. I am hoping this is the year for it to bloom. It would be a first time bloomer for me. And here I have my Pastoral Innocence. Also got a massive division taken care of last year to make sure I can keep it because it's a big orchid. But look at the size of this growth. There's no stunted growth that I can see here. So it took to that intervention really well. With one exception, it did absorb one of the back bulbs, but that's to be expected. But to see this growth coming in now, and it's not any smaller, I'm hoping that this is the year I can see this one bloom. Cattleya iricolor is just busy on the root front. That little nubbin there has not moved since the last time we saw it, but the roots are well established in the pot now. And then in my previous tour, I was concerned about the blackening. You can see that that's dried off and the growth has not been affected at all. But I have my little Speciosum Matsuru here, who has been working on roots in the pot throughout all these months and is now coming out with a new growth back here. Can you believe it? Last year, I repotted it at an angle, expecting this was the previous growth, expecting it to come out from somewhere here, not from the back. And yeah, I'm gonna leave it. It has plenty of room, but I might need to think about maybe next year, if it's gonna pull that same stunt, I'm gonna have to think about maybe moving it into the middle of the pot, which was not part of the plan at all. But still, new growth, finally, and that will bring more roots with it. And my previous growth is still beautifully variegated. And then we have here, of course, the Maxillaria tenuifolia, which is not the common variety, but a beautiful bloom nonetheless, and finally identified. And I did take back my initial discontentedness regarding Klassen and their labeling, but hey, here we are. It is in tenuifolia, and it is beautifully fragrant, like coconut macaroons. Another thing I have here is my Lelia tenebrosa. I do still have a sheath in here, but it's still empty. I wonder if this is gonna grow this year. Bloom this year. And there's no sign really of new growth activity at the base, excuse you. So we're still waiting on that. The next one up here, still no activity regarding growths at the base. Here's my Brassavola Rincolalia digbiana. And it's just nuts in the roots. This whole pot is filled again. And we'll have to see about next year, maybe having to do a rejuvenation of sorts again. Oh well, don't mind. Just give me those roots, I'm fine. And then over here, we recently did a care collab on the Osteocladus bathulifera. That growth is coming along nicely, despite the repot, all okay in the pot. And my Siamese doll kiwi over here is just focusing on roots. We had an early spring, late winter bloom, which I thought was out of season. There's no sign of new growth at this point, but working on roots, and I'll take it. In the back here, I have another Sunya green, which had a massive repot rejuvenation and division last year. That's this one right here. So I have Sunya green and Sunya green mailman. But again, this one also has never bloomed for me. And it has taken the sulk a little bit to an extreme because it's only just now seems to be swelling its little growth at the base. So I am wondering if maybe this time around, if these growths were to mature and want to bloom, I may actually get them to bloom because they won't be doing it in the hottest time of year. And that was probably the little secret to them blasting their buds previously. I would understand that now. And then just to love and leave you, I mean, there's more going on over there. They're all onto their silicon soaks as well. But those are mainly from the blooming alley. So I think I've covered most of them the other video. And I'll leave a link of that in the description and put up a little card. But there's more silicon soaking going on over there. Look at this. Guess who this is? Guess. Pacabia Beach. First time bloomer. We're going to have something very, very spectacular, I hope, if she's not mislabeled. But right there, Pacabia Beach. Happy days. I'm going to go now and show you something else, and then I will love and leave you. We are still on the east side, but I brought up the two little Angraecum leonis that I have because of the angle of the sun. This was one of the shaded parts. I had pulled the curtain back and I just put them up here so that they don't get scorched. But I wanted to show you that one of them is in full root production mode, which is awesome. And I am losing a leaf there, but another leaf is coming, which I love. I love seeing leonis leaves come out of the center there. And you can see how much bigger it has gotten since we did the care collab video on that. This leaf has matured beautifully. So the span of the orchid is starting to be approximately 20 centimeters per leaf. That's great. I'm really, really pleased with the development of this one. Gorgeous roots there. And the little one here, I do believe I have two of the same, just different stages of maturity. But this one is already in the process of maturing a new leaf. I lost a leaf there off to the right, but there's also been new root activity. And for that, I am super grateful. I don't want these guys to feel any kind of lack of humidity around them to abort these roots that are growing now. So they live right at the bottom of my east side shelf, protected up against the wall, where they get a lot of light reflecting off the wall, but never direct sunlight just yet. I'm very wary of the sunlight and these guys. I'm just moving across here, checking the leaves, because now it is time to flush out all the pots and refill according to the needs and what the orchids are doing, either with plain RO water or with fertilized water. There's going to be a lot of flushing and a lot of splashing going on, and that is going to be amazing. I love this time of year. I don't have to worry about getting wet feet, cold feet, etc. All good fun. Thank you so very, very much for watching. I appreciate it. If you see any orchids here that you also have and would like to join me in on a care collab, please leave me a comment and I will put you on the list and I'll be in touch. And then we can do some collaboration videos together. That would be amazing. Have yourselves a wonderful day, everybody, and please stay safe and take care. Bye.